Greetings. This is part 7 reviewing an Islamic poem titled, O Christ Worshippers. The author, Ibn Qayyim, lived from 1292 to 1350. Can you believe these same arguments have been repeated by Muslims for 700 years? We were taking a look at Psalm 22, a prophecy of the Messiah. My God, why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far from saving me from the words of my groaning? My God, why have you forsaken me? These are the very words Jesus spoke from the cross of crucifixion. Oh my God, I cry by day, but you do not answer, and by night, but I find no rest. Yet you are holy, enthroned on the praises of Israel. In you our fathers trusted. They trusted, and you delivered them. To you they cried and were rescued. In you they trusted and were not put to shame. But I am a worm and not a man, scorned by mankind and despised by the people. Messiah would be despised by his own people. Matthew 27:22. Pilate saith unto them, What shall I do then with Jesus which is called Christ? They all said unto him, Let him be crucified. All who see me mock me. They make mouths at me. They wag their heads. Matthew 27:39. And those who passed by heaped abuse on him, shaking their heads. Mark 15:29. Those who passed by heaped abuse on him, shaking their heads and saying,
Aha! You who are going to destroy the temple and rebuild it in 3 days.
Luke 23:35. The people stood watching, and the rulers sneered at him, saying,
He saved others. Let him save himself if he is the Christ of God, the Chosen One.
All who see me mock me. They make mouths at me. They wag their heads. Without a doubt, this describes what Messiah experienced while crucified. He trusts in the Lord. Let him deliver him. Let him rescue him, for he delights in him. Matthew 27:43. He trusts in God. Let God deliver him now if he wants him. For he said, I am the Son of God. Prophet David reveals that Messiah would be mocked. And Islam claims that Allah sent David and the Psalms. Remember, the Quran claims Allah sent David with the Psalms. Color me silly, but if my religion said that my Allah sent some named prophet with a known book we have copies of, if I had any serious respect for my Allah, I would be driven to learn what his book said. But I sure as heaven would not mock it as stupid. Only depraved infidels mock the certain word of Allah, right? Yet you are he who took me from the womb. You made me trust you at my mother's breasts. On you was I cast from my birth, and from my mother's womb you have been my God. In part 5, I read this and commented, This sounds familiar. Yet you are he who took me from the womb. You made me trust you at my mother's breasts. On you I was cast from my birth, and from my mother's womb you have been my God. I said something about that sounded familiar, right? Let's get to the next refrain of our poem of Islam's wisdom and sincere respect, quote-unquote, for Allah's Psalms, and see what awaits an answer.
What a sight it was, a grave that enclosed a god. Stranger still is the belly that confined him.
Uh-oh.
That sounds a little strange, using the word stranger.
Stranger still is the belly that confines him. He stayed there for 9 months in utter darkness, fed by blood.
And now I know what sounded familiar. This 700-year-old Muslim is happily mocking Prophet David and the Psalms his Allah claims to have sent. Doesn't that just make you just want to blow yourself up for Muhammad?
Stranger still is the belly that confined him. He stayed there for 9 months in utter darkness, fed by blood. Then he got out of the womb as a small baby, weak and gasping to be breastfed.
Yet you are he who took me from the womb. You made me trust you at my mother's breasts. On you I was cast from my birth, and from my mother's womb you have been my God. Prophet David reveals the mystery of the Messiah being given a body, being knitted into human flesh, inside Mary. If you are a Muslim, can you tell me if you can find a single Muslim in history who has rebuked this poet for mocking Allah? You see, my Muslim brother, the idea that Messiah, the Son of God, God in the flesh, would grow in the womb is neither shocking nor ridiculous to us, because we respect the prophets, while your religion teaches you to mock the prophets. Hebrews 10:5. Therefore, when Christ, Messiah, Messie, came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me." Here is the full and honest answer why Christians are not shocked by Jesus in the womb. Jesus, the Messiah, the Son of God, is an eternal spirit who is one with God. That means Jesus existed before all of physical creation came into being. In that ancient time before creation, Jesus had no physical body. So, when Jesus came to earth, God needed to create a physical body for him. Therefore, when Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me." And how does a physical human body grow and come into being? Inside a woman's womb. In Jesus's case, inside Mary's womb. And if you thought about it, you would have to agree this is how a human body is created. I think the real problem you have, brother, is trying to grasp how Almighty God could enter into a baby's body. And I really want you to ponder, brother, whether God can do something you cannot imagine. Please give this serious thought, brother. Is your Allah limited by what you imagine he can do? Can the Allah you are willing to worship, can this Allah do anything beyond what your mind can imagine?
Stranger still is the belly that confined him. He stayed there for 9 months in utter darkness, fed by blood. Then he got out of the womb as a small baby, weak and gasping to be breastfed.
It is clear this Muslim poet mocks God for doing something the poet judges as strange. Does Islam really teach you to mock what Prophet David revealed in the Psalms? To mock and judge Allah's words? This is a vaunted and lauded and heralded Islamic poet, thus proving Islam's real heart toward the God of Abraham.
He ate and drank and did what that naturally resulted. Is this a God?
Ah yes, the Jesus pooped jihad. 700 years old, and still a steaming pile of error. It is as if Islam never lets you advance beyond the toilet training stage. He ate and drank and did what that naturally resulted. Is this a god? And dear Muslim, this is why Christians, in a less spiritual mood, think Islam is too stupid to follow. Do you not know that Allah swears by toilets, and Allah swears by pigs, and Allah swears by what food naturally results in? Quran 69, I swear by that which you see and that which you do not see. Allah swears by everything you can see. Can you see poop? Allah swears by it. So why is a Muslim poet mocking that which Allah swears by? On you was I cast from my birth, and from my mother's womb you have been my God. When one respects the prophets, we are able to learn, brother. Notice what this revelation by Prophet David says. From my mother's womb, you have been my God. Jesus could not refer to God the Father as his God if Jesus had not been born of a natural birth. And there is another reason deeper still. There was a purpose for Jesus to be born, to be a man. Jesus had to, so that he could, as a man, conquer original sin. Romans 5:12. Therefore, just as sin entered the world through one man, and death through sin, so also death was passed on to all men because all sinned. Not to get distracted, but sin is what causes death. Therefore, just as sin entered the world through one man, and death through sin, so also death was passed on to all men because all sinned. The one man through whom sin entered was Adam, for sin was in the world before the law was given. But sin is not taken into account when there is no law. Before the law, before the Torah, sin was not measured as a violation. Nevertheless, death reigned from Adam until Moses, even over those who did not sin in the way that Adam transgressed. He is a pattern of the one to come. But the gift is not like the trespass. For if the many died by the trespass of the one man, how much more did God's grace and the gift that came by the grace of the one man, Jesus Christ, abound to the many? Jesus had to be a man. Jesus had to be born to be a man. Jesus had to be a man so that his act would counteract the action of the first man, Adam. 1 Corinthians 15:20, but Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For you Christians paying attention, the password is first fruits. The first fruits raised from the dead during the feast of first fruits. Nudge wink, say no more, say no more. For since death came through a man, the resurrection of the dead comes also through a man. For as in Adam all die, so in Christ all will be made alive. But each in his own turn. Christ, the first fruits, then at his coming, those who belong to him. First fruits. There's that word again.
High exalted be Allah above the lies of Christians. All of them will be held accountable for their libels.
Empty, words, baseless conjecture. Blustering threats to scare and impress fools with no knowledge. From a poet who mocks the Allah, he now pretends to praise and exalt. Remember, this poet mocks Prophet David and the Psalms from Allah. Maybe, just maybe, you should go watch this video again, O Muslim. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.